Hello and welcome to Learn Statistics class. In this class we are going to learn the statistical concept in simple and more easy way. The topic of today's lecture is gamma distribution. In this topic we are going to learn the additive property of gamma distribution. Additive property means if we add the gamma variates, then the resultant distribution of the sum of gamma variates is also a gamma distribution. Hence we say that gamma distribution has additive property. So let us start with the additive property of gamma distribution. Statement: suppose x1 is a gamma variate with parameters theta and n1, and another variable, random variable x2, which follows gamma with parameter theta and n2, then x1 plus x2 follow gamma theta with parameters n1 plus n2 and theta, provided x1 and x2 are independent. This property is known as additive property. So let us start with the proof of additive property of gamma distribution. We know that since x1 follow gamma theta n1, then the MGF of x1 is mx1t is equal to 1 minus t upon theta raised to minus n1 with t upon theta less than 1. In the previous lecture we have already learned what is MGF and how we calculate MGF in case of gamma distribution. If a student want to learn MGF in detail, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that corresponding lecture is also given in the description box. Okay, we will move to x2. As x2 follow gamma theta n2, then its MGF is given by mx2 t is equal to 1 minus t upon theta raised to minus n2 with t upon theta less than 1. Let me call these two as equation number 1 for further references. Suppose y equal to x1 plus x2. We will calculate the MGF of y. Consider the MGF, moment generating function of y. By definition it is MYT, and which is equal to expectation of e raised to TY. Let us put the value of Y. We know that Y is nothing but X1 plus X2. So it is expectation e raised to tx1 into e raised to tx2. Since we have given x1 and x2 are independent, then this myt is equal to expectation of e raised to t x1 into expectation e raised to t x2. As x1 and x2 are independent, e raised to t x1 and e raised to t x2 are also independent. So by the theorem of mathematical expectation of independence of random variable, the expectation of product of two independent random variable is equal to the product of their expectation. We have already learned this theorem in the topic of mathematical expectation. If student want to learn the more detail about this theorem, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that topic is also given in the description box. After observing this final equation, this one, we observe that the first term expectation e raised to t x1 is nothing but the MGF of random variable x1, and second term expectation e raised to t x2 is nothing but the MGF of random variable x2, that is mx2t. So myt is equal to mx1t into mx2t, and from equation 1, mx1t is 1 minus t upon theta raised to minus n1 into 1 minus t divided by theta raised to minus n2. This is from equation 1, which is equal to 1 minus t divided by theta raised to minus n1 plus n2. This is the MGF of random variable y, and which is sum of x1 plus x2, and x1, x2 are gamma variates. By observing this equation, we say that y follow gamma distribution with parameter theta and n1 plus n2. Since this equation is the MGF of gamma, theta and n1 plus n2, hence by uniqueness theorem of MGF, we say that y must be gamma with parameter theta and n1 plus n2. Hence, gamma distribution has additive property. In this way, in this lecture, we learn what is the additive property and how gamma distribution obey the additive property. We prove the equation that if x1 and x2 are individually independent gamma variates with parameter theta and n1 and theta and n2, then if we add these two variables x1 and x2, then their sum x1 plus x2 is also a gamma with parameter theta and n1 plus n2. Hence the theorem. In the previous lectures, we have already learned many more terms from the gamma distribution. If student want to learn that all terms, then click on the I button at the top right corner of the screen, and link of that lecture is also given in the description box. Many more concepts which are already discussed on Learn Statistics channel are also given in the description box. Anyone can refer from the description box or by clicking on the I button at the top right corner of the screen. Students are requested to subscribe Learn Statistics channel for the next upcoming lectures notification in the upcoming days, and share with your friends in order to learn them the statistics subject in simple and more easy way. In the next lecture, we will meet with the next topic. Till then, we will stop here. Thank you.